Kirit Parekh panel, the expert group tasked with suggesting a methodology for pricing diesel and cooking fuel, submitted its report to the oil minister yesterday. Some of the recommendations: hiking diesel prices immediately by 5 rupees a litre, capping diesel subsidy at 6 rupees a litre, and so on. Tanvi is standing by with some more details of what those recommendations were. Tanvi.
Harshad, the two main important ones are what you mentioned: an immediate price hike of 5 rupees per litre, and then capping the subsidy burden to about 6 rupees per litre. Those are the two crucial ones. He's spoken a lot in his report about the way the calculation should be done as far as the diesel subsidy and the price is concerned. Pretty much in line with what the industry was expecting. So on an overall basis, it's actually good news for OMCs as well as upstream companies, but probably not so much for customers, at least in the initial few stages, if it is implemented. Now, the larger question here, of course, is when does that happen? The ministry is going to take a call, discuss it further internally before really doing anything. But the market right now is not really taking this seriously. They don't expect any kind of movement from the government's front until the elections are over. This is way too controversial and, you know, an anti-populist measure as they see. So the markets are not reacting to this news right now. But just to give you some sense of what the, his thought process here is, so he's saying that you need to use the NELP mechanism to come for a pricing for the diesel itself. And the fact that the burden on the upstream companies needs to reduce. That definitely has to happen, whether it happens at an immediate point or in a staggered way. But at some point, that burden really needs to come down to zero, and they shouldn't be paying as much as they are at this point of time.
Sure.
There is initially a formula given for what the crude price should be. If the the international crude price is at a certain level, what does that mean in terms of subsidy sharing? So it's all pretty much in lines of what the corporate world was really expecting. But of course, more importantly, we'll have to wait and watch of how much of this really gets across in the at least the next 8-10 months. It's highly unlikely that you'll probably see anything, which is what the market is saying.
Sure. Thanks, Ami, for putting that in perspective. You know, Kirit Parekh has been talking about freeing up or liberalizing the sector for a while now. This is not the first report that he submitted in this regard. The question that Tanvi is pointing out is how much of this is feasible. Sumit Jha, our reporter, caught up with Mr. Parekh right after his recommendations were announced. And Parekh detailed what he believes would be the consequences if his suggestions were not implemented. Listen in.
What happens if you don't raise diesel price? Your under-recoveries go up. And as your under-recoveries go up, your fiscal deficit goes up. Money supply goes up. As money supply goes up, inflation goes up. Inflation goes up. Interest rate is raised by the Reserve Bank. Interest rate goes up. Then you find that investment goes down. So you get a higher inflation and lower GDP if you don't do anything than if you are to do something.
One last question, sir. I know it's not your job to implement it. You think in the current political situation, your recommendations will be implemented to the fullest?
I mean, it will be very optimistic to think that it will be implemented to the fullest, but one always hopes that some things would be implemented. And that is always, I mean, one always works. I mean, I have worked in policy analysis for 50 years maybe, and it's always the case. You always work with the hope that something will happen. As Pandit Nehru said, if in India, if you lose hope, nothing is left.